They have announced their intentions very clearly that they want to add up to 30 gigawatts of capacity. So in the end, it is all tied to that bigger goal of, you know, adding 30 gigawatts. And just to put it in perspective, I mean, the entire gigawatt capacity of all the hyperscalers combined is around that ballpark, 30 gigawatts. So they are talking about, you know, some big numbers in terms of capacity additions. How they will do it? One is through a deal with Oracle. So that was a $300 billion deal. Then they signed a $250 billion deal with Microsoft. So when you look at it from that perspective, $38 billion is not that big. And look, I mean, I can see what OpenAI is doing because they've seen, you know, Anthropic sign a deal with Microsoft first, and then they signed a deal with Google TPU. So Anthropic and OpenAI are the purest plays when it comes to LLMs. And if Anthropic is getting all that compute capacity from the two hyperscalers that, you know, OpenAI was doing business with, it was mostly Microsoft. And then Microsoft added Anthropic. So from that perspective, I can see why OpenAI wants to go to Amazon, which they haven't done so far.
It's an arms race, essentially.
Yep.
Yeah.
Anthropic, OpenAI, these are private companies, correct?
Yeah.
Where are they getting this cash for all these big purchases and investments and things? Am I missing the funding rounds here?
Well, so look at what they have done in terms of their valuation. OpenAI has grown to $500 billion in valuation this year. They started off the year at around $200 billion. So that just goes to show that every funding round, they have attracted more money. In fact, people are lining up to give them money.
Wow.
Now, I mean, granted, their revenue is still, the latest numbers are close to $15 billion in ARR. That's growing over 100%. Of what they have promised to investors is they'll get to $100 billion in ARR by 2027, 2028.
What is average annual revenue?
Annual recurring revenue. Okay. So that's where, that's how we measure all the software companies. When you think about even $15 billion in ARR puts them among the top 10 software companies. So already OpenAI is among the top 10 software companies.
You walk in and I want to poke holes in it, but he's got such
conviction
about this.
I know. I'm shaking my head as he's talking about this.
He's got such conviction.
Mandeep, is there a point where OpenAI gets so big that it has to go public, that it can no longer stay a private company?
I mean, they already changed the structure where Microsoft got a 27% stake now.
And so
yeah, but they're like multiplying in growth. So this will last for a little bit. And then the same question arises again, doesn't it?
It does, but they are separating out the nonprofit part with the profit entity that will go public, and then they will sell their shares. I don't know how much money they would want to raise given how much they are already raising in the private market. So look, I mean, it's inevitable. A company like OpenAI, if they get to $100 billion in revenue over the next 3 years, they have to be a public company. I just can't imagine them being private. And
are there regulations that push them in that direction? I mean, isn't it you have a certain number of shareholders, and at some point you have to list?
I mean, think about the backers of the company who are participating in these funding rounds. They would want an exit strategy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're kind of becoming an investor right now with the hope that you can get a return. And so once a company gets to $100 billion in revenue, I'm sure a lot of those investors would want an exit.
Google announces big CapEx raise, stock goes up. Facebook announces big CapEx raise, stock goes down. Why?
Because at the end of the day, you have to show ROI and you have to show revenue. In the case of Meta, they are planning to spend over $100 billion in CapEx next year with no explicit cloud revenue. So think of what Amazon's $38 billion deal does today. It will add $5 billion in revenue starting late 2026 and 2027 onwards. Every year, this $38 billion means they'll add $5 billion in revenue. That's how much OpenAI will end up paying Amazon. Mm. In the case of Meta, they're spending $100 billion plus with no promises that somebody will pay for their infrastructure. Yes, they are getting some lift in their ad pricing, but that's not enough to justify $100 billion in CapEx. So that's where the ROI question is the most obvious in the case of Meta, because obviously they keep raising their numbers and they keep
calling
supply.
What does Meta say they're gonna do other than advertising? What does Meta say they're gonna get from that $100 billion
in
CapEx?
Their pitch is we've got, you know, this family of apps with over 3 billion monthly active users where people are spending 40 minutes a day. We will give them more AI functionality. Look at what OpenAI has done with AI-generated content.
Yep.
What Meta is saying is our AI-generated content will be better than you know, these LLMs, and that will drive engagement, and we'll monetize it via ads.
Right, but they aren't able to provide explicit numbers in the same way yeah. that others are able to. So isn't that a good sign that equity investors are discerning, are making a distinction between Meta and Amazon and Alphabet and Microsoft, that you know they're poking holes in some of these narratives that the companies are telling?
Absolutely. I think right now the market is making that distinction, which is why Amazon actually trails so far. It's only after their recent print that you got a lift in Amazon, and you know now with this deal, suddenly they're starting to see some more monetization for Amazon.
So does that show that even if you're kind of late to the party as Amazon was, you can make up for lost ground, that it's the race hasn't gone too far ahead of you?
I mean, the path right now is through AI infrastructure, renting AI infrastructure, whether it's power or data center capacity or GPUs. That's where everyone is convinced there is revenue and there are profits. When it comes to applications, it's still very hazy in terms of which business model will actually generate profits or not. So I think the market has done a good job in terms of discerning where the monetization is so far.